All right. Down the hole again. Probably should have checked for secrets before jumping down the hole, but meh. Elevator. That's where I dropped it. And land on something. Dang it. Where am I going? Oh. Definitely missed that. If I could even have gotten to it from here, probably couldn't have.
Going this way does
was nothing down there. Where'd those bullets come from? Scattered in hell, abandoned by their clergy and reinforcements, the Sentinels proved their worth in what would be their final war with the forces of all evil. Unrelenting power in the face of certain death, the Sentinels crushed hundreds of demons and skewered titans. When their Atlans held no more fuel, the Sentinels took to the ground and fought the swarms on land. All of hell knew of the betrayal, for it was without question the Makers and the Priests who had sowed the seeds of deceit long before the brave warriors passed through the gate. What Hell saw that day was the beating heart of the free people of Argent Dinur. They did not flinch in the face of their own certain death. They died as they lived, with sword and shield in hand, Urdok too low a place to house such giants. Theirs would be the fate of warrior gods, remembered for all time. Lord Sash, the stalwart banner sergeant, was found with his war standard pierced through the throat of a great beast, his body surrounded by the corpses of enemies. Rowan the Mighty, the light faded from his eyes, had eviscerated such a multitude that their entrails clung to the black rocks like vines. Gore, relentless until the end, had broken his blade on the backs of his foes, and by the time he fell he had slain another 20 with his hands alone. The priests believed the Sentinels all slain, but we are Argenta, born to overcome. Rumors, deemed heretical by the Order Daeg, persist and claim that the Slayer himself still rages in the unholy realm. None who live can know, for the future of Argent Dinur has been bent and twisted by the perverted vision of the Essence Drinkers. Never again will the light of the race illuminate our world. All has fallen. If the Slayer does live, let him carry our vengeance forward. If he persists, let him wreak violence on those who have wronged us. May the blood of his sword never dry. May his war never end until the guilty have been punished. And may this evil never again spread its shadow over another world. Or in other words, rip and tear until it is done. Alright, there's something right there. Mastery token. Press right to unsheath, then press R2 to cleave demons. Each demon costs 1 pip. Replenish the crucible with crucible. Oh, alright.
No!
fast travel. That was not helpful. Thank you. so there's two things I'm missing. Might as well go... Nah. It is just a drop from that area. That might have been it. But I fell far too far. Yeah. Right, no, it wants, I'll be wanting to go on this side, apparently. Yeah, that's facing the correct direction. I saw it. Sure what I missed, but I definitely missed something.
Erdak is the Maker's homeworld. It is not accessible to anyone. No human or sentinel has ever set foot in their dimension. You can use the Maker's origin factory in the Hell City of Necrovol to pass through the void. Once there, you will not be able to leave on your own. But Vega can create an exit portal for you. That is why you must bring Vega through the void with you to Erdak.
Understood. I'm detaching myself from the ship's systems. Processing. Total transfer to external drive complete.
Vega is no longer connected to your ship. I will reconfigure the portal to Necrovol for you. acquire anything else before we begin our journey to Erdak. You will not be able to return until the mission is complete.
Last chance.
Attention, this is an emergency broadcast from the Ark Resistance. Numerous reports from survivor cells across the globe are confirming that at some time within the last 24 hours, the demonic invaders have begun amassing in swarms near Gore nests. Ark scientists have theorized that this behavior is indicative of the arrival of a super predator, a world eater. Ark personnel advise all survivors remain in the safe zones.
Gates. Every mod unlocked. Okay, so no reason to go to the first time because away. Up there, huh? Thank you. still fits. Unlock classic marine outfit. Well, I was hoping that would let me get up into the crawl space somehow. Guess not, though. Could upgrade that or upgrade literally everything else. Nice. Arsenal. What do I want to upgrade? I haven't even started on that. Targeting range increase, meh. Rote detonate, lock on burst, arbalest. What does this do? Movement speed increased, size of explosion. Recharge instantly after a direct hit. Should probably upgrade something to the arbalest. Rapid chains. Charge time decreased by 20%. That's useful. No idea where they put it. I know I got other stuff to do. Exultia. I got 5 weapon points to get. Infinite overdrive. All Praetor perks unlocked. Infinite Onslaught. All weapons are unlocked and mastered. All weapons have infinite ammo, infinite extra lives, and Sentinel Armor. Alright. Now that I have incredible weapons and a nearly 100% upgraded suit, bonus stuff should be easy. Yeah, that's what I was missing in the last place. Barrel.
Thank you.
I go left, I'll get an extra life. Enough. life over there on the right.
There is a Sentinel power core nearby. You can use it to activate the mech and clear a path forward.
Nice. There's the secret encounter right there, and then there's the other encounter right there. Thank you. trek. Log entry. stairwell ran out. I had to start cutting. Don't care. That's everything though. Return to campaign. Save what I've earned, but abandon the currently selected mission. Yes. Bonus stage. Every single time it disconnects, I have to go through this connecting anytime I load an area. And I always forget about it before it's way too deep into the load screen to pretend that I just didn't have one. Yeah, there we go, finally.
Do you require anything else before we begin our journey to Urnak? You will not be able to return until the mission is complete.
Yes, yes, I know. Now, where's that thing with the chicken? There it is. Let's see if this actually works. Nice. Alright. So, just gotta do that 5 more times. Probably. Maybe? Dope saw. Never look directly down the barrel of a gun. Especially not one this large. Ooh. Shiny. Apparently the source of the Hellzone grenade. Basic gun. And the crucible. Dang, can't read the file names. Best kills compilation? Baby fix? No idea. Something, something, something. Something picks. I don't know. Thank you. 9 of 14, so I need 5 more discs. Already got. Marauder. Shiny. Pain elemental. Ugh, those are hands. No legs, though. Called so for its distinct coloration. Its diet is primarily flamingos. Prowler. Okay. I didn't get many new toys anyway. Alright, one story of Earth thing left, found in Final Sin. Story of the Sentinels, already done. Stories of Hell, found in Necroval Heart 2, found in Erdok. Alright. Found in Erdok. Undiscovered entry, which is super descriptive. Undiscovered entry. All right. So not much more left to find. Kill 2 demons with single heat blast 30 times. Kill 15 prowler demons with lock on blast. So 3 more of that and 30 of these because I never use the heat blast effectively. Suit, I got 0. Arsenal. Mobility, fast loading. Heat blast, microwave beam. Lock on. Destroyer blade. Kill 3 enemies 15 times with destroyer blade. That shouldn't be too difficult. Next time, another mission replay.